recovery. And to give us a sense of the unique tools and skills needed for such a job, CNN's David Mattingly is here to give a demonstration and to give the willies to claustrophobics everywhere. He is off the coast of Vancouver, David.
That's right. We are 50 feet down in Horseshoe Bay in British Columbia, and this is really a remarkable experience. We're only 50 feet down, but the conditions here are very similar to what a manned mission might encounter at the bottom of the Indian Ocean where they're searching right now. And Phil Newton is with me. He's an international deep dive expert, and he actually develops the vehicles like we're in right now. So Phil, you've been explaining to me tonight how this is sort of a game of inches. It's something very delicate. If you're going to go down to collect a black box, you just can't go down and grab it and zip right back up.
No, that's very true.
And while you're doing that, show us. We've actually got a mock-up of a black box right here in the claw already, the arm of this vehicle. And just show me that it's a very delicate operation just to put it into the basket that we need to put it in to carry it back up to the surface. And while you're watching this, notice how the water is moving and how cloudy it is here. Sediment can be a problem if you stir it up. It's almost like blowing into a handful of flour. You would be blind for a while. And every motion like this, you would just have to stop, wait for the sediment to lay back down before you could start over again. And this is right in front of our face right here. And still, that's not an easy thing to do, is it?
No, not at all. In fact, you described it very well. It's a game of inches, because as you move through wreckage or, recovering something like this data logger, you're stirring up the bottom. So you have to keep stopping, waiting for the sediment to settle down, and then inching it forward. You don't want to lose it, so you've got to be very careful, A, not to damage it, B, not to lose it, and to get it in position where it's safe to bring up. Right now, this looks like it's only partly in the box, but in fact, the manipulator is now, now holding it in position, so we're safe to bring it up in this condition.
What would be the most dangerous thing about being that deep underwater when you have so few submersibles that are capable of reaching those depths?
Well, of course, one of the things that comes to mind if you're in a manned submersible is that you like to know that there's some rescue assets that are capable of reaching you in the event of trouble. With the case of an ROV, one of the big problems, of course, is the umbilical. And that is
the ROV. These are remotely
operated vehicles,
and they have those tethers that
go all
send
the way
them
to the
information.
Surface, that's right. And it's not just information. The power for their thrusters comes from the surface, so they're relying on that to be able to move. They're relying on the communication link to be able to see where to move, and of course, but anything that's fitted with vertical thrusters, which all ROVs are and all subs are, every time you thrust vertically, you're going to kick up a lot of the dust on the bottom.
Right, and that's one of the advantages of having a pair of human eyes down here. I mean, if you're looking, you can see just how much sediment there is in the water right now. And we have these very bright lights, four of them on the outside of this vehicle that we're in right now. And still, Bill, we can only see about 4 feet in front of us. So you would have to know exactly where that black box is to come down and then grab it with the claw before you can take it back up on the top.
That's very true. And that's where things like ROVs come into their own, because they're able to go down and survey the situation and possibly do the work that we were just doing here, but also pave the way and do the location for the manned subs that might come down.
So robotics possibly to do the scouting, but then it takes the human touch to actually go down and retrieve the black box.
Yep.
But again, Bill, as you can see, nothing down here is going to be easy.
David, what a great
Absolutely
illustration.
Right.
What a great illustration of the difficulty there as well. And who knows, how long they would have to pick through that plane to find the black box going forward. Appreciate that intimate interview you guys are doing down there. And we come back.